Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on how to reset a check engine light or other various engine lights. Right off the bat, it's important to make a couple quick notes and talk about a few things before talking about how to actually reset and delete a check engine light or another light. It's usually not advised to do this unless you know what the issue is and it's something that isn't serious, and you just wanna see if deleting the code and resetting the check engine light takes care of the problem, or maybe it's something that has already been fixed and you just wanna go ahead and get that reset so that you don't have to drive around for 30 minutes with the engine light on before the engine light actually disappears and everything resets. So one quick example of that is something like an engine misfire typically isn't a serious problem. And a lot of the times when an engine starts misfiring, it can just be something that's intermittent. So maybe you just want to go ahead and reset the check engine light, get rid of that code, and see if the misfires continue to happen, or possibly sometimes with a misfire, it could just be a one-off fluky issue. And so that could be an example where you might want to go ahead and reset the check engine light, or something else simple, like maybe you didn't tighten the gas cap on fully, so you're getting some sort of evap code, and that's what's causing the check engine light, and those you might just want to get rid of right away. Anyway, that said, there are a few different ways to reset a check engine light. Not every single one of these that we discuss is going to work on every single car, make, model, and year out there. There is a little bit of variation, but a couple of these ways to actually reset the check engine light or other vehicle engine lights typically work on just about any car, but again, a couple of them can be a little bit of toss-up as to whether or not they work on every vehicle. Number one, one simple way to potentially reset the check engine light or any other light that you may be receiving on a vehicle is simply restarting the engine. And now you might need to restart the engine 2, 3, 4 restarts to see if anything happens or goes away. Ultimately, this won't usually work. However, restarting the car a couple times can reset the computer, and if it's an insignificant fault, restarting the car a couple times might help the ECU or the car's computer realize that whatever it picked up on before is no longer there, or it wasn't a serious fault or anything that should be triggering a check engine light at the current time. Again, just try turning the car on and off a couple times. This won't work for a lot of problems. It really depends on what the underlying issue is that triggered the check engine light, but it can happen from time to time. One example I know, something that I've experienced numerous times, especially with one of my BMWs, is it is turbocharged and occasionally it runs into a random fault. This doesn't happen often at all, but maybe once every few years, there'll be a random fault that sends the engine into essentially reduced power, a limp mode, or a low or no boost mode. Whatever it is that causes this, sometimes it must just be something random on startup, but usually whenever I notice that light, I just go ahead and restart the car. Even after one quick simple restart, that will usually completely get rid of that reduced power engine light and everything is back to normal. So again, that isn't a usual thing, but it really depends on the issue at hand. And sometimes weird things can happen on a startup and something may get picked up wrong, or the car's computer might just do something weird or get a weird signal for a brief moment. And a couple simple restarts can possibly get rid of that check engine light and reset whatever light you're getting. Number two, another way to reset the check engine light or any other light on a vehicle is just to continue driving for a little bit and see if it goes away on its own. Now, of course, whether or not you should do this depends on the actual light that pops up. And depending on the symptoms or severity of it, you might not want to continue driving the vehicle at all. However, again, circling back to that misfire example, if you get something that suggests there's an engine misfire or nothing seriously feels wrong or off with the vehicle, then occasionally just driving it for a little bit will reset the ECU. It will no longer pick up on that code in a given time frame, usually about 20 to 30 minutes. So if that fault doesn't occur again over that 20 to 30 minute drive, then chances are the engine light will go ahead and just go away on its own. As a quick example, I actually had an experience with that in a different car of mine a couple weeks ago. I know it's coming due for a spark plug replacement, just haven't quite gotten around to it yet. So I got a simple check engine light that typically on that specific model indicates a misfire or similar issue, something minor and not a major issue in the grand scheme. Driving the vehicle felt totally fine, felt totally safe. There were no symptoms. The idle was normal. The power delivery, everything felt normal. So I continued driving since I still had a 30-minute drive ahead of myself. And once I had stopped at a gas station and turned the vehicle off and turned it back on and drove for a few more minutes, That engine light totally disappeared and it hasn't popped back up since then. Now again, I know that car is due for spark plugs and it was likely just a simple misfire that happened one single time due to some spark plugs that are on their way out getting a little bit older. So just a quick example of something that happens that if you continue driving, that check engine light will go away. Another thing that can frequently cause check engine lights that will go away on its own is a gas cap. If you don't properly tighten your gas cap after filling up on gas, you might trigger a check engine light. After retightening that gas cap and driving about 20 or 30 minutes, that light should go ahead and just disappear on its own. Again, number two, continue driving, see if the engine light goes away, but definitely don't do this if something feels seriously wrong with the vehicle or if you're getting other codes like the engine is overheating or something seems seriously wrong or dangerous with the vehicle. Then definitely don't try that method. Something serious probably is going wrong and you should probably pull over in a safe location sooner than later, rather than just driving and hoping whatever the issue is clears itself away. Moving on to our third way to reset a check engine light or any other light on a vehicle is disconnecting and reconnecting the battery. Now, as with a couple of the other issues we already discussed, this will not work on every single year, make, and model. On some cars, by disconnecting and reconnecting the battery, it totally resets the ECU, the engine's computer essentially, which can also be referred to as the ECU, the DME, or the PCM, depending on make and model of your car. But ultimately, disconnecting and reconnecting the battery can occasionally reset the PCM or the ECU altogether on some vehicles, and at that point, that will delete any fault codes that were stored in the vehicle's computer before that could be triggering that check engine light. So on some makes and models, disconnecting the battery and reconnecting it is a surefire way to go ahead and reset that check engine light. Again, on other cars, it is not quite going to work. So just something to be aware of before you spend the time and effort disconnecting and reconnecting the battery, since it can take some time and a couple tools on hand. Also, as one note, it is very important to follow proper procedure when disconnecting the battery. So you do want to make sure the car's computer is asleep, that the ignition is not on, that no electronics are on. So this does vary on some cars. On a couple of the BMWs that we have, the computer and some of the electronics will actually stay awake for a while after you drive the car. So the best way on a car like that is to pop the hood or trunk wherever the battery is, completely lock the car, make sure everything's turned off, and put the key away from the vehicle, especially as a smart key, and just make sure everything goes to sleep before you actually try to disconnect the battery. And then on any car, it's very important when you do disconnect the battery, always do the negative or the black terminal first before you disconnect and remove the positive terminal. So a couple things there. It does make disconnecting and reconnecting the battery a little more complex than some of the other steps and methods for resetting a check engine light that we're discussing in this video. But again, disconnecting and reconnecting that battery on some years, makes and models can be a surefire way to go ahead and get everything reset and get rid of that check engine light, at least for a little bit until it possibly comes back if there is an ongoing issue that the PCM or ECU then picks up on again in the near future. Moving on to our last way to delete and reset a check engine light or any other vehicle light is one of the most surefire ways on any car that has a modern OBD2 port. So pretty much anything from 2000 and onward should have an OBD2 port. And using a simple OBD2 scanner, you can go ahead and read any fault codes stored in the vehicle. And you can also delete the fault codes, which will essentially delete them from the car's computer's memory. And that will essentially delete any check engine light or any other light you're receiving. So with that, we'll go ahead and jump in and show a quick example of this with an OBD2 scanner for those of you who may have one and need a little guidance in terms of reading and deleting codes with an OBD2 scanner. All right, hey guys, sorry, it's a little dark out here, but hopefully we'll pick up most of this. So again, with the OBD2 scanner, this will simply plug into the OBD2 port, which is usually below the steering column and the steering wheel on the driver's side of the vehicle. So on this 2002 Chevy Suburban here, it's just right here, right by the parking brake. And so that'll plug in, but again, usually it's down anywhere in this general area. Sometimes it could be on the side here, either of the sides, but either way, you'll find it here on the driver's side of the vehicle. This is our OBD2 scanner here. It's a little bit of an older one. So with the OBD2 scanner, it depends on what model and what OBD2 scanner you can get. There are some expensive ones and some cheaper ones. It's just a very cheap, basic model. But you can see here, you can select a number of different makes. Hopefully this will pick it up here. So again, this is a 2002 Chevy. So we're just going to go ahead and select General Motors here. We can do a new scan. And while this is all plugged in, one thing to point out quickly, the engine doesn't have to be running, but the ignition does have to be turned on. So we already have the ignition on. We are connected to the car's ECU or PCM, basically the computer. And right here we can read any DTCs or diagnostic trouble codes. So if we click this, we can see this vehicle currently doesn't have any DTCs. It doesn't have any faults stored. Unfortunately, we didn't have a car with any engine lights to actually show a physical example. But anyway, you could read this. It would show what the fault code is, what's wrong with the vehicle. Another option, again, this will look different depending on what OBD2 scanner you have. But you'll see the option here to erase the DTCs. So if we go in here and do this, we can hit enter again to actually delete them. Of course, again, there aren't any on the vehicle. But nonetheless, it'll give us a message that the erase is successful. And at this point, any check engine light or any engine lights would actually be deleted. Again, if the problem is something that is still ongoing, once we drive this car for 20 or 30 more minutes, those engine lights would likely come back if it's an ongoing problem and not just a one simple fault that was fixed, or maybe something that was a one-off instance. But anyway, that's the OBD2 scanner. One of the easiest and most effective ways to actually go ahead and read and delete any engine lights and fault codes stored in the car's computer. All right, guys, and we're back in the garage. Ultimately, hopefully that quick OBD2 example showed up okay on video and gives everyone a good idea for those unfamiliar with an OBD2 scanner. The OBD2 scanner is going to be the simplest and most effective approach out of everything we've discussed in this video in terms of resetting and deleting any check engine lights and any codes that are stored in the car's computer. So if you don't have an OBD2 scanner and you're looking to do this kind of stuff on your own, then we'd highly recommend getting one. You can pick them up from generally any automotive store or on Amazon. Some lower end, cheaper ones, I believe, are about $20 or $30. Some higher end ones can run $50 to $100 plus, but if you just need it for simple stuff, then you don't need anything fancy. You can just get a cheap model that at least gives you the basic functions to read and delete those DTCs. And once those troubleshooting codes are deleted, that should in turn delete the check engine light or any other lights you have on the vehicle. Quick summary here. We highly recommend against deleting or resetting any check engine lights or any other lights on your vehicle without having a good understanding of what's going on and making sure it's not a serious issue or it's something that's already been fixed and you just want to get rid of the check engine light, rather than driving around for 20 or 30 minutes and waiting for it to go away on its own. So for that reason, again, that's why the OBD2 scanner and these code readers are so important, because not only does it give you the ability to delete a check engine light if it's something insignificant, but it also gives you the ability to actually read the fault codes stored in the computer and see if there is anything seriously wrong with the vehicle. With that said, that wraps up our video for today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.